Today, we have a job in Sparta, New Jersey. It's going to be installing synthetic grass in a dual-use batting cage and putting green area in a residential backyard. All three of the guys are coming today to help out, so I'm going to go pick them up. You better go grab your boots. Come on, let's get rolling.
/6:24, just coming into the lot. I have to pick up some 3 foot wide cut weed barrier for the batting cage dual purpose putting green area because it's 14 feet wide. So the big rolls that we have in the truck right now are 6 feet long. Instead of running a whole other piece and cutting off 3 feet of it, it's just easier to go with the smaller roll. So I'm gonna go scoop one of those up real quick and then head over and pick up Dom and go through the rounds of picking everybody else up. But it is 54 right now. It's muggy out. As you can see, it rained yesterday. It rains every day, if you haven't figured that out by now. But we gotta do what we gotta do. See if we can get one of these out without toppling all these. Oh yeah, it's like playing Jenga. Oh, got it. Anything else we need? I don't think so. Let's go get Penny. Get her warmed up. Boy. Can't forget my tater tots. Make some room for the guys. I don't know why it doesn't unlock when you put it in park. If anybody knows, I would like to know too. Come up here.
No. This is my spotless.
Good morning.
What's up?
How are you? You feeling all right? It's better to do that in like the city because there's more people that are in rent.
New York?
Any cities.
Oh, yeah.
Whether it's Bayonne or else.
Good morning, Brett.
Good morning. How are you? It's pricier because there's more people that are competing for those prices. Supply and demand. We're talking about rental properties and investments.
It doesn't matter where I buy them. It'll be good deals.
Well, you don't want to go buy them out in Bumble, Pennsylvania, you know, where it's there's like three people that you have in a market rather than here. We have, say, 65,000 or so. That was there forever.
And Yellow Rose has been closed down, the one uptown.
Well, it's all like, you know, second generations, or the person who started it is just getting too old and they want to retire, so they shut it down. Nobody's keeping it going. But they do need to be renovated and updated. I absolutely agree.
Yeah, but the Lucas, there's like the whole family is in that joint.
Well, it was, yeah.
Oh, so that means they must have retired or it went down.
It was the same thing with Bellicarello's. The whole family was there. They sold that. Same thing with Chances. The whole family, it was, the parents owned it and the kids ran it. And that went, so they tried to sell that and that deal went under, so it's just sitting there vacant right now.
We got a new worker today? Man, he looks like you in the morning with your hair all roughed up.
Right here. Good morning. How you feeling, Wilson?
Mm-hmm.
All right.
How much did I build?
15 bags for the batting cage. And then a 74-foot roll. You good? Good morning. You got a new guy?
Yes, this is Omar.
Omar, how
First
are you?
Today. So,
right. Very nice to meet you.
Pleasure, brother.
You know how to forklift?
Yeah.
Good.
Yeah.
We need more guys like you.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
I just finished doing construction, so yeah.
Okay. Sure.
I'm ready.
You're under good hands with Rocket Man here.
He doesn't believe it.
I'm gonna get
Vanessa Sherry
from Rocket Man.
Can I add something? Can I get two putting green cups?
4-inch, 6-inch.
The 4-inch ones?
Is that six? The taller ones? 6-inch?
4-inch.
I heard 4-reach. I'm like, what do you mean
4-reach? 4-inch? 4-inch? Yeah. And then can I get an American flag?
Okay.
You have two?
You have the rods and everything else? Usually we sell the.
No, the whole kit, whatever you guys...
So we sell the pin sets. We sell cup, base, rod, knob, whatever flag that you need.
Yeah.
So it's a full kit.
Do that.
So
can I get two of those?
Yeah, so you sell the American flag, right?
Yeah. We only do American style.
Some might say, yeah. All right, I'll get that ready for you.
All right, appreciate it. Thank you. Jason, is that you?
Yeah.
I'm Joe, nice to meet you.
Joe, nice to meet you.
This is my whole crew, I don't know if you want to know their names or not. Willie, Dom, and Wilson over there.
How you doing, man? Let me show you to the back. It came down all day Sunday, and then it got heavier at nighttime.
Oh, boy.
Where are you coming out from?
From Bayonne. We got a little bit overnight, but, you know, it is what it is. Yep.
So, Sure it is. I hope it's to your liking.
Okay. No, that's good. We'll come in here for just final grade it. You already put the putting cup in there?
Yeah, the other guy did it.
Okay.
Not sure how good it is.
We're going to have to set it a little lower.
Yeah, I kind of assumed, yeah. Depending on where you do it.
Okay. Do you have pins also, or do you, because we,
pins?
The pins.
No,
the
I
flags?
Don't.
Okay.
Yeah.
Does that center stuff move out?
Yeah, the cage?
Yeah.
The L screen? Yeah, I can move it here.
Okay. You don't need to do it now, that's fine, but okay. All right, cool.
Question, are you covering this or no?
We're going to go inside of that.
Inside of it?
Yeah, just so there's not that lip up to it.
Yeah.
Because
yeah.
If we tuck it to the top of this, I mean, uh-huh. I think I mentioned this before, we had a bunch of text messages, but what happens is this will essentially settle over time, and then you'll start to pull away, and yep. You'll eventually get that lip. And to be honest with you, it doesn't look good, number one. And number two, you know, it's kind of a tripping hazard because you're not really used to it there.
Yeah,
so it's better to have a defined edge that we can tuck the turf directly up to.
Okay. If you have extra, eventually I might want to put some on it, if you don't mind.
Well,
the extra.
You said this was 14 feet wide, right?
Yeah, you got 14.
So there's going to be a whole other strip of it, which is 15 feet.
Okay.
So you're going to have one strip. I guess you can do 6 inches on both sides that way, left and right.
Yeah.
You'll have enough? Okay.
Yeah, I mean, I can do that with time.
Yeah. Okay.
I mean, the poles are there and it's a pain in the ass.
Exactly. That's pretty cool, though.
Yeah.
All right. Cool. All right, so we're going to unload the truck.
Not do it.
We're gonna install 74 feet of sports turf in this residential backyard. So underneath this netting is a batting cage / putting green area, and it's surrounded by 6x6 timbers. We're gonna put turf running the entire way back up under here. So we're gonna get going. Guys are gonna unload the truck and start moving. We got half a day to put this together. And it's misting. Oh, you got turf right here. Let's stage the stuff for when we're gonna need it. So. Put that. Get this. I don't think we need that.
No?
No. Take these two up so that he can double check those putting greens. We'll put them in the wheelbarrow. Hold on, there's a lot more stuff that needs to go up. Don't just go up with that. Just be careful with these so they don't break. See if those pins go into those cups that he has.
We're not gonna use any nails.
Right? No. I think that's good for that. Take that up. And work with him on getting that putting green, or the cup set into the ground. Just leave it here for now. I don't really know where it's going.
If it's perfect,
yeah. It does?
Yep.
Okay. So you want to just grade a little bit to the top of that surface and we'll call it a day?
Yep.
All right, I like that. Can you help me? Because you're strong. Can you help me get this stuff out of here?
It's got wheels.
Oh, no, I didn't see that.
You can carry that one.
Oh, I...
You can carry that one.
Give me that. I got it. Got it?
I got it. I think I got it.
You think? I got you.
Watch out for the propane tanks, cause they go kaboom. You know? You don't know. You don't.
You already know you're gonna cut this turf. Wanna get that shit up?
Let's just bring it. Let's haul it in here. We'll unroll it as much as we can. Flap the sides over, like whatever, and we'll rip those sides. That way, when he's finished, we can just drag it right back and call it a day. Right. I'm just hoping that the weight of it won't pull those putting cups out. We got to come in this way. I don't want to go near the propane. Yeah. And let's see where it's rolling first. Yeah, let's take your end in first. Watch your toes. We're going. Oh boy. We're stuck.
What do you think, bro?
It's right there. So,
I can get it on.
It's gonna tip over. Do me a favor. Hold on, hold on, hold on.
Let's wait. Definitely get it over.
Hold on, hold on. Just turn it this way.
This way?
We'll just keep it here. See if we can push it up. I guess that's good enough. We'll go with that.
Leave it.
We'll straighten it out. See if you can pivot your end. There we go. Okay. Let's kick it off. So we're gonna be taking from here, we'll push it up and pull it back. Push it up and pull it back. That we can start feeding it in. And then grab a couple more bags of staples too if you can. So get one of those, the 6 foot rolls, and then one of the 3 foot rolls. Thank you. The problem is, it's only 14 feet wide and now they got these poles here, so we just can't roll it in and push it out because we're gonna fight with that. So we gotta pull it out and fold the flaps in. And we gotta try to stay clean on here.
I know.
And also I don't want any of these big rocks getting in there. I thought that cage is supposed to prevent the leaves from being in there. Oh. Do that again.
From this side or the other side?
The weed barrier.
Are you putting these in?
No, leave those out there. Because we don't have much room. I'll help you, no big deal. We got you. We're like straight in the mountains right now. You're a mountain man. A mountain man. So, have you ever seen a deer in real life?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. Have you seen a bear in real life?
No.
What would happen if you saw a bear? Would you run?
Shoot. No.
Shoot him. You better not be carrying guns in my truck. Is Willie ready for this?
Yep. He said I can start running.
Okay. I hope so.
Or does DJ have it?
I don't know.
You got your blade or DJ's got it?
You wanna start kicking that down?
You got your blade or DJ's
kick,
got
kick,
it?
Kick that down. Yeah, I'll stop. Right down the middle. We'll put it up to the edge so we can be nice and clean about it. Right. We gotta go up and over. See if you can pull that tight a little bit. We got some wrinkles over here.
You got wrinkles?
Yeah, lots of them. I'm getting old. I'm getting old and frail. You good?
How many more than five staples?
There's only six. One, two, three, four.
For what? I'm talking about down the entire thing.
Oh, you're doing the whole thing? Is that enough?
Yeah, 12 should be enough. He gave me another four. There you go.
Let me get a couple for the top of this one.
You too? Corner's finished, yes sir. Take more?
Yep.
Better get those back if you don't use them.
Oof. Wait, I gotta check that top piece. The middle's not next to the
one. It's okay, we can kick that over. As long as you pull it tight, you're good to go. So pull it tight and cut it, and then you can wiggle that into place. Nice job. So I'm gonna set like 100 of them on this leading edge so that this doesn't come up, and then peel all the way back underneath this thing. All right, Tom, you ready?
Yep.
Are you sure? This is gonna be muddy.
Move this a little bit more?
Yeah, if you can. Try to see if you can put it on the other side of the arborvitae. Does he know what an arborvitae is? Sad right there. Drag it. Does it, well, you're gonna have to fold your end in on, so about a foot. What? Because this is 15 feet, that's 14, and the poles aren't gonna allow you to roll through. Unless you want to take the poles down. Okay. So fold your end in, fold your end in, and then pull it from the middle. But grab both the top and the bottom. You know what I mean? So that way you guys are more direct pulling straight in. Starting to rain, guys. That's always fun. What side do you want to set? Yours?
It doesn't matter.
You want to run down there and cut that? This side?
Three?
Whatever you can get, stay on the same bead. See how the beads are smaller? You want to start, we'll get the weed barrier out of here, back in the truck. We'll get the, leave the claws, leave the hand tamper. That's all right.
You want me to start bringing these?
You can leave those for now. Get the weed barrier. That one right there.
Oh, I'm gonna see that.
Get the weed barrier out of here. Get rid of this stuff, right? Joe, get your shit together. You're gonna stay here for the customer. Don't load it too heavy. I won't be able to carry it.
I'm gonna push it. I'm gonna push it,
go.
I can't pick that up, man.
I'm gonna push it.
You're gonna push it?
Yeah.
Oh, then go.
Yeah, he's looking at me. Can't pick
that up. I'm not gonna pick that up.
I'm just making sure the wheels are right.
It's the grass, that's the fucking part.
Look at the power, the brute strength. That's good, perfect, right there. No farther. Nice work, Dom.
Pull the rest to the other side.
What's the plan here?
You gonna flop that over?
Flop it over?
I mean, my back is torn up. I can't, so.
Trying to get that, all that excess. Trying to line up that edge.
This.
No, we're trying to line up the edge of the curve, so we'll put it on that side.
Hey, Willie, pull this out. We'll
pull all that excess
off. We'll do a little bit at a time. Okay, all right.
Oh, there's another fucking rock under there. down here?
Well, I told him to watch out for
it. We gotta pull this up. There's another big one over here somewhere.
I think it was over here somewhere. There, do me a favor. Roll like 5 feet of it in. This whole the whole way. 5 feet of it in. Make it all flat. Can you do the same thing down there? So five feet in from that ledge, flop it over 5 feet. So we're only dealing with a little sliver to maneuver this, because fighting this No, I know, but to maneuver this into place. So flop it over 5 feet. Because we're fighting this net way too much. Flop it over. Wilson, stand on that end down there. Dom, grab the pullers and pull that straight so that it's nice and flat across the whole thing. That way we know we're starting on a good base here. So you gotta come in more. That's not 5 feet, that's like a foot and a half. Pull it in more. There you go. Now pull it straight on that back edge, the corner.
Corner?
Yeah. Pull it. I know, hold on a second. We're just gonna. Don't trip him. Okay, all right. I think so. Yeah. So now you guys can grab it and pull it that way, right? Are there any more rocks to be aware of?
I thought before was the last one. I think we're good now.
Okay. All right. Are you still on down there?
Yeah.
How much room you got? So do we got to go towards you more or no? Because we got another 2 feet over here.
The thing is the wood. He's all the way up to the wood.
Okay. So you want to start down your way?
Yeah.
Why are you doing that?
I'm going to back kick it. It's this much I got to pull.
Okay. I was gonna say you're gonna fight the net again. The whole reason to fold it over is so you can just pull that little thing like he's doing. Just,
yeah.
Like that. That's perfect. And then we'll come in here back kick that.
Yeah, pull that axe. It's not hard though.
Just a tad.
Yeah.
See this bubble? Okay. That way you guys aren't screwing around with the net all day. That's too much. I'll move it back, don't worry. Hold up. I didn't go.
He didn't line it up.
See if you do a little pull from that corner out. Just a little bit. Perfect. Right there. Boom. Done. You see how that works?
Yep. I like your logic.
You like? We gotta pull this way anyway, Willie. This has gotta.
Yeah.
That's good there. That's good. Okay. So now we'll walk it into place over there. You think we can grab the carpet knife? The push knife? And rip off a foot? When we fold it and flop it over, so it'll be a nice straight cut. There you go. Ah! Stuck. You gotta pull this out.
Straight up.
Keep going. Okay. This is getting really muddy. I think we gotta have shoes on, guys, shoes off, guys. Because this is already a mud pit.
Yeah, so.
Shoes on. Shoes on? Alright. So. There's a rock here, too.
Shoes off.
So, you wanna.
That's what I'm saying, you gotta be shoes off.
Well, no, once you're on, you're on. Don't coat off so you don't step into the mud and come back on. So, rub your feet off. You wanna do the nailing? We'll do cargo running in and out. So I ask him where he wants to cut that. Willie, you're gonna be on the turf. We'll be off the turf, all right?
What?
You're gonna be, you and Wilson are gonna be on the turf, and we're gonna stay off because it's getting way too dirty.
Okay.
So if you need something, yell at us, all right?
Yeah.
Stay off the turf.
There's definitely rodents around here taking shits.
There's what?
Rodents around here taking shits.
Of all the fucking
wow,
things.
Wow, what is supposed to like straight up asshole?
I thought
asshole.
You said bears.
No, I said rodents.
There's definitely bears out here taking shit.
Rodents out here taking shit. I was by that wood. It smelled like a whole... Nigga,
Dom? Dom does.
You didn't smell that by the wood?
No, I wasn't over there.
It smelled like poop.
Poop? Shit.
It was one of y'all pooping on yourself.
Shit. Literally shit. You gotta cut this. You got a knife? You gotta cut this. I don't, and Dom does not.
DJ's got it.
Bro.
You're gonna. Joe!
Oh, you can't go in and you can't go in. He tried to make it open.
Just cut that, and then cut this too.
He said we're supposed to be off the turf, and he's still on it.
Yeah. I never went off. There's a rock under here, rock under here,
yeah,
rock under here.
But this is easy to pull up in the middle of it.
We're gonna do this edge first, going that way?
Yeah, before I start cutting that thought, I wanna make sure this is set and I pull at any slight wrinkles like that.
There's a few, just a few. I mean, we're not getting sun today, so it is what it is for whatever.
I can't exactly pull it closer to the edge with Joe's fat ass standing on it.
I'll get off once he's doing this.
You're supposed to be on.
Exactly. You're here. You're supposed to be off.
I'm off.
Or you want to switch?
I'm here. No.
That's still on.
All right, I'm off.
Thank you so much. I appreciate you.
Watch out. As long as you don't touch the other turf.
That's right.
Now we got two guys that need to.
Thank you.
see my blade?
Yeah, you threw it at your brother.
No, he got it.
He just got it.
I do not. You gave it to him.
No, he didn't give it to me. He just cut it and I started rolling.
Oh, I fell off. Well, here, you gotta roll this one up too.
More excited about this than my kid. Yeah, just, you know, play golf and just something to do.
Yeah, we have enough room back here. You might as well do something with it, right?
Yeah, it took time, man. This took time.
Yeah. I mean, you still have some pretty good hills and valleys. You could probably do a little putting green back there too if you wanted, or a chip and putt.
I want to do chip and putt over here.
Yeah.
Right from here to there, from there to here, but it's a lot. A lot of square footage.
Yeah.
Not sunk in?
No.
Look at
get
him.
Get the little thing, it's like the other two. You just move it and then.
Oh, the same thing?
And
oh.
Then go like that.
Okay,
you don't see. I got you.
But leave that one in on the edge so they know where you started.
Yeah.
So work on the second one in. Please, and thank you. Starting to rain on us pretty badly now. It's about 11:30. Willie cut out all of the turf around it. Dom and Wilson are stapling around the perimeters. I got this, Dom. I'll do this. You keep stapling. You finished? So I need to make a decision whether we're gonna start dropping this infill or not. Because it's wet, it's not gonna be able to lay down evenly. So it's either we wait until tomorrow when it's supposed to be somewhat sunny, or we give it a shot today and just leaf blow the heck out of it. But we'll see. We'll see how it goes. There's a 15% chance of rain today. Like I said, there's rain clouds following me around for at least a year and a half now. So hopefully that changes. Could really use some luck on my side. The flags are in the truck. I'll grab them next time I go back.
Where they're in the truck? I'll go get them.
In the driver's side dash, right on top. I think it's unlocked. I'll just unlock it again. Thank you. We're doing good today. You know, everybody's in work mode. I feel like just because I busted my back and I really can't do much, that they're trying to pick up the pace, and, you know, I absolutely appreciate it. I know we got 6 jobs at least, and we got another Brooklyn job we gotta get done before Memorial Day, so we're out here in the rain doing what we gotta do. I got enough water coming from the sky. Only thing the American flag is a nice touch?
It's extra.
It is extra. These are expensive.
much them shits cost?
For two?
Yeah.
You couldn't afford them. All right, it's pouring rain. It's way too wet to infill. So we're gonna pack up, come back tomorrow. It is 12:15 right now. We got the turf down, they nailed it all up, cleaned everything off. We got the infill lined up around the side. We got the flags in, it's flat, it's green, and it's wet. So we're gonna come back and take care of that when we're able to infill it. It'll be dry. There's no sense in fighting with it now. It'll just take way too long and it'll turn out like crap and we'll have to come back anyway. So let's choose our battles. But I don't know if you can tell, everything's soaked out here. I'll come back tomorrow. I thought that was the truck. All right, we're back. We tried going to lunch, and as soon as we got out of the truck, ironically enough, the sun came out. So, we're gonna give it a shot, brooming this in. Is it still gushy back here? Oh, it's better. Got a lot more to go. How do you think it came out?
It was alright.
Good job. We are gonna head back to Bayonne. Hopefully these rain clouds stop following us, but better make sure you cut it straight. See you on the next one.